Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Heavenly Father, we come to you again, and we thank you for allowing us to praise you openly and freely.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. We are having a good time because of you. And we thank you, Lord, that you allowed us to come together again and lift your name up. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we thank you for it all. We thank you, Lord,
thank you,
for
Jesus.
It all. Thank you, Jesus. And we ask, Lord, that you will continue to work in all of our life that we may be changed for the better. Please, Lord, help us to make a step forward spiritually. In Jesus' name I pray. Continue to use us to the full to help and encourage your people. Please, Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. Lord, now touch us all as usual. We all need a touch from you, Lord, and we ask that you would touch every last one
right
of
there,
us.
Lord. Right there,
now,
right
Lord.
Right there, right there.
Thank you, thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you for that touch in advance. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Father.
Thank
continue
you,
to work on us.
Yes.
Continue to mold us.
Oh,
to be, Lord, what you have us to be. Not what we think we ought to be, but what you have us to be. We thank you for it. We thank you for it, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Now, Father, we ask now that you would just touch our pastor, Lord, that you would re-strengthen him right now, Father, that we ask that you would give him a double portion of anointing right now in Jesus' mighty name. And we thank you, Lord, for it all. We thank you, Lord, for it all. Now, we can't get enough of you. Let us have more of you, Jesus. Let us have more of you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we thank you for it all.
Thank you,
we
Lord.
Praise you, Lord. We worship you.
Well.
We magnify you, and we glorify you. In Jesus,
Jesus
it's all in Jesus' mighty name we
Hallelujah.
Pray now. Amen and amen.
Amen, amen.
Come on, let's praise him right now.
Thank you, Jesus.
House.
Thank you, Jesus.
We're talking about Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Come on, say it. I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
Highly favored.
Highly favored.
I'm special.
I'm special.
And I'm God's favorite.
And I'm God's favorite.
I'm a friend to God.
I'm a friend to God.
And God is my friend.
God is my friend.
He loves me.
He loves me.
More than I love myself.
More than I love myself.
And there's nothing I could do.
There's nothing that I could do.
Absolutely nothing.
Absolutely nothing.
That I can do.
That I can do.
To stop him.
To stop him.
From loving me.
From loving me.
Y'all give the Lord a hand and clap of praise.
God bless. That's it.
Today, I'm doing a message, brand new message.
Oh, yeah.
Titled, Life Made Joyful.
All right. All right.
Look at your neighbor and say, your life needs to be more joyful.
Needs to be more joyful.
Life made joyful. And for those of you who are already flowing in the joy, I'm going to say more joyful.
Amen.
Life made joyful.
Yeah.
Joyful is one of those words you don't hear too much. Normally, during the holiday of Christmas, joyful. When I was young, Mama always taught me that joy coming in the morning.
Uh-huh. Amen.
I done got to the point now where I'm not going to wait till morning
for
my joy.
Yeah.
Just like I walk by faith, I must... Lord, have mercy. Stay in that joy.
Come on now.
I walk and I got the joy with me when I walk. The world didn't give me joy. And the world can't take joy from me. My joy come from on high. And it's up to me. Somebody say it's up to me. If I want to receive joy, flow in that joy and live a joyful life. If you're not living a joyful life, your life can be made joyful. If you ain't living a joyful life, your life can be made joyful. Whose report are we going to believe? And the choir said, we will believe the report of the Lord. Whose report will you believe? And the congregation said, we will believe the report of the Lord. I believe the report of the Lord Jesus. And the word of God says, you know, he's the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. God is the same. God ain't changing up on us every time something go down. Somebody say amen. And what's so good about it, we are children of God. Now this morning, I'm going to share a little something with you concerning one of God's children. Somebody say amen. I'm going to share just a little bit. His name is only mentioned like twice in the entire Bible. Somebody say amen. His name is Jabez. Somebody say Jabez. I want to just read to you a little bit. Jabez was labeled, somebody say labeled, with sorrow at birth. But his prayer against contracting sorrow nullified the label. Later on, his life contradicted his name. He became a well-respected man. He's only mentioned, now it says three times, but his name is only mentioned twice, and then it's mentioned and spelled a little differently the third time. The first time is in 1 Chronicles 2:55, where it says, Jabez is the name of a town. Now, it's better known as a city. Somebody say amen. Amen. And it says, during an uneventful time in Israel's history, Jabez prayed a simple, straightforward prayer and gained favor and blessings of God on his life. The second time is found in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, 9 through 10. And it begins at verse 9, and Jabez, somebody said Jabez, was more honorable than his brethren. And his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow, somebody say, I bear him with sorrow. And Jabez called on God, the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed and enlarge my coast, and that thy hand might be with me. Somebody say, thy hand be with me. And that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And God, come on, say it with me. And God granted him that which he requested. Y'all give the Lord a hand clap. Lord have mercy. That's pretty much it. Now, I guess say, what am I going to get from that? What am I going to get out of it? He only mentioned twice. Somebody say amen. But the Bible says he was more honorable than his brothers. Didn't say his brothers wasn't honorable, but he was more honorable than his brothers. And his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow. I bear him with sorrow. I'm not bearing him with joy. I'm bearing him with sorrow. Is something going on in my life that's causing me to be sorrowful? I'm going through this pregnancy. There's travail. Ain't saying nothing about his daddy. Somebody say amen. But it had to be something going on in his family that caused him to become a person of prayer. And the Bible says the effectual fervent prayers of the righteous availeth much. It says his brethren, more honorable than his brethren, and his mother called his name, oh my God, and I bear him with sorrow. And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, he called on God. Dear God, can you help me out? Can you bring me out of this thing? Father, I need you to work a work in my life. I need you to work a work in my family. I need you to touch my family. I need you to touch my father. Right here, he's not mentioned, so I'm going to assume they didn't know where he was. Somebody say, man. Maybe he had to go away to a faraway place. I don't know. But it's just not talking about him. And the reason he's not talked about is so we can understand that sometimes daddy just may not be there. Somebody say amen. But even though the father wasn't there, God touched one of them sons. And that Holy Spirit, that power of God, made him more honorable than his brethren. Somebody say, more honorable. I would love to be more honorable. Somebody say, I would love to be more like God than everybody I know. Somebody say, more honorable. I want to be more faithful. I want to be more trustworthy. Somebody say amen. And so the Bible says he was more honorable than his brothers. Now, I ain't saying much about his brothers either. Okay? It was as I bear him with sorrow. And Jabez called on God, the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me. Oh, God, if you bless me. This is what I'm going to do, dear God, if you bless me. And when you share with God you're going to do something, you know you got to keep your word. Now, obviously, this man kept his word. Because later on, you find that there's a city called Jabez. Somebody say amen. Now, you're going to go from praying to God for help to having a city named after you. Somebody say amen. Somebody say a city, a whole city named after him. He was an honorable man, more honorable than his brothers. This is a man that trusted God, that God would come in and touch everybody in his family, touch them from the top of their head to the bottom of their feet. Somebody say amen. I'm believing that joy came to the family of Jabez. I'm believing that joy came to his mother. Somebody say amen. It says, oh, that thou wouldest bless me. Indeed, and enlarge my coast, and that thine hand might be with me as I do this thing you asked of me. As I go forward, somebody says, I go forward, as I go to the next level, as I lead my family, as I provide. Somebody say, amen. And that thou wouldest keep me from evil. He's saying, I don't want to get involved with that. I need you to strengthen me. I need you to keep me. Somebody say a straightforward prayer. Father God, in Jesus' name, keep me from evil. Keep me from evil. Touch God in such a way where I become strong, where I don't get into evil like I used to, where I won't sin like I used to. Somebody say amen. And that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it might not grieve me. And if any come nigh me, it's not going to bother me. It's not going to grieve me. It's not going to cause me any harm. Somebody say amen. And God gave him what he asked for. God granted him his request. God said yes to Jabez. Somebody say amen. God said yes. In Psalm 3:2, it says, many there be which say of my soul, there is no help for him in God. They got some people that think no matter how strong or how close you get to God, it ain't nothing going to change. Somebody say amen. Said, that's a lie from the pits of hell. Because the closer you get to God, Lord have mercy, it begins to affect everything around you. Somebody say amen. The more closer you get to God, the more you learn of him, the more you learn to love and trust him. Because when you get close to him, he gets closer to you. Somebody say amen. Oh, Father, if you would just allow me to get close to you. Let me get close to you. In Psalm 12:1, it says, Lord, help. Godly men are fast disappearing. Where in all the world can dependable men be found? Somebody say, in faith. Hallelujah. Lord help. Godly men are fast disappearing. Somebody say, amen. David said, Lord, this is godly men. Where are the godly men? Has everybody gave up? Somebody say, no. Where are the godly men? They're in faith. And they're walking with the Lord. There are still godly people left. Somebody say amen. There are still God people. There are still God-fearing people. Somebody say, I'm a God-fearing person. And I know how to call on the name of the Lord. I know how to be straightforward. And I know how to come to the Lord, praise God, and reverence him. I know how to explain what I need to explain. And I know when I don't have to explain anything. Because sometimes the Holy Ghost let me know I don't need the backstory. Somebody say amen. Where are they? Where are they? What's this? And sometimes they're natural, look like that. Sometimes it looks like you can't find a God person when you really need to encounter one of them. But you got to believe this. If you don't run across one of them, you got to understand that Jesus is not afar off. Everywhere you go, he's up in there. Somebody say amen. Everywhere you go, he's around up in there. It says, many will be with yourselves, my soul. There is no help for him in God. In Psalms 12:1, Lord, Lord, this is Lord, help. Help me. Help. Godly men are fast disappearing. Where in all the world can dependable men be found? Somebody say, in Christ. Psalm 20:1-6. In your day of trouble, may the Lord be with you. Father, I need you. When you feel like you're going to call out, Father, I need you. Come on, somebody. Jabez wasn't the only one who could be straightforward and talk to Jesus. Somebody said, I could talk to Jesus. You need to believe that he is, that he's a reward of those that diligently seek him. It says, may the God of Jacob keep you from all harm. Somebody say, I receive that. It says, he send you aid from the sanctuary. Aid, somebody say, aid from his sanctuary in Zion. He remember with pleasure the gifts you have given him, your sacrifices and burnt offerings. So the Bible says, God remember all that you do for him. Somebody say amen. It says he remembers. It says he send you aid from his sanctuary in Zion. He remember. Somebody say he remember. He remember with pleasure the gifts you have given. He remember with pleasure. He find joy when he remember what you done. Somebody say amen. It says he send you aid from his sanctuary. From glory comes your aid. He remember with pleasure the gifts. Somebody say, the gifts you have given him. Your sacrifices, he remember every sacrifice that you made. Somebody say amen. And burnt offerings. Somebody say, we ain't got burnt offerings no more. But he remember your offerings. He grant you your heart's desire and fulfill all your plans. Somebody say, fulfill all your plans. He'll assist you and help you and lead you and guide you into filling and strengthening you so you could fulfill your plans. God wants you to complete, Lord have mercy, your assignments. There'll be shouts of joy when we hear the news of your victory. Flags flying with praise to God for all that he has done for you. May he answer all your prayers. God save the king. I know he does. He hears me from highest heaven and sends great victories. In Psalms 141-5, watch this, King James. Deliver me, O Lord, from the evil man. Preserve me from the violent man, which imagine mischiefs in their heart. Continually are they gathered together for war. They have sharpened their tongues like a serpent adders. Poison is under their lips. Selah, keep me, O Lord, from the hands of the wicked. Preserve me from the violent man who have purposed to overthrow my goings. Somebody say, I'm finna live this life for joy. I'm finna live this life with joy. This life of joy, I'm finna live. Said, I'm finna live. Said, I'm finna live. I hear about terrorists and all that. I ain't finna let no terrorists stop me from living a joyful life. I know it's a lot of crime going on, but I'm not finna let that stop me from living a joyful life. Somebody say amen. Bills ain't gonna never stop. I ain't gonna let that stop me from living a joyful life. I may not have much money as I think I desire, but I'm not going to let that stop me from living a joyful life. Somebody say amen. I may not understand everything about God, but God and the heavens have spoken. I'm supposed to live a joyful life. I'm supposed to flow in that joy. Somebody say amen. I don't care about mischief. I don't care about tribulation. I'm going to live a joyful life. God put us here to live a joyful life. You're going through, and bring yourself out. Live a joyful life. Live a joyful life while you're going through. You can choose whether or not you want to live a joyful life. Every time you have ever become sad, you made yourself feel that way. You chose, I'm going to be sad now. The heaven declares this. You chose. Whenever joy came upon you, you chose to receive it. Sometimes it was some tool that God worked through, or something that God worked through that, you know, provoked you to receive your joy. God doesn't have to work through anything for you to receive your joy. The joy is there. Just receive it. Somebody say amen. Nobody got to bake you a cake and put candles all around and you. I don't need no cake. Somebody say amen. Ain't nobody got to tickle me for me to flow into joy. Some of us, we want to be tickled. Somebody say amen. Joy comes from God. Joy is received by choice. I choose to flow in this joy. I choose to be content. Somebody say amen. I choose not to allow whatever thing to disfigure me and have me flowing in sorrow. Have me aching in pain. Have me calling stuff on myself. About to quit, about to give up. No, that's not who I am. See, we as believers, we never quit and we never give up. The heavens has declared it. Joy is here right now. Joy is in this room right now. I got something to be joyful about. I'm alive and well and blessed, highly favored. Lord have mercy. I'm a child of God. I'm excited about that. God has answered my prayers. I'm excited about that. I got a promising future. I'm excited about Ray Ray and Snookers. They're all right. All is well. I'm excited about that. God has given me something to be joyful for. You can't count the blessings. God has blessed you so much. You can't even count them. I'm glad my heart is beating right. My heart. How many? Raise your hand if your heart's still beating. Raise your hand. Your heart beating right now. Don't that feel good? I like that. I like that. I'm glad I ain't locked up somewhere. Somebody say amen. I'm glad I ain't lost. Somebody say amen. Now, when I was lost, I didn't have much to be joyful. Okay, you understand what I'm saying. I don't want to talk about hell and all that, but I didn't have much to be. When I didn't have Jesus, I didn't have much to be joyful. Somebody say amen. It says, which imagine mischief in their hearts continually are they gathered together for war. War, rumors of war, I'm going to keep my joy. And if I think I'm going to struggle with it, Father God, in Jesus' name, please help me keep my joy. The stuff is about to hit the fan. Sometimes you got to call for reinforcements. Somebody say amen. Angels in heaven, do your thing, because I'm going to keep my joy. They coming out now. They're coming against me. I'm going to keep my joy. I want to stay in my joy. Keep me, O Lord, from the hands of the wicked. Don't let them succeed, Lord. And in Jesus' name, I'm glad about that. Because God has stopped them. Preserve me. I'm preserved. Said, I'm preserved. Said, I am preserved. Thank you, Jesus. From the violent people. Say people. Say it. From those spirits. It says in verse 5, the proud have hid a snare for me and course. Now, that's enough to upset somebody when you find out that You know, there's evil lurking here and there. But God says you need to flow in the joy. They have spread a net by the wayside. They have set chains for me. Selah. Look at that. Look at that. A net. It's like a spider's web. Somebody say, man. Just, well, y'all ever seen the spider? The spider just waits. Somebody say, man. The spider has the web all just going every which way. Somebody say, man. And the spider is waiting for some other insect to just land. Somebody say, man. But I don't get caught up in webs. Somebody say, man. Said, I don't get caught up in stuff. Said, my God done already hit me to that. Y'all give a Lord a hand, say, I'm hip to that. They got me once. They ain't finna get me again with that same. I learned the first time. Somebody say amen. Said, I'm not worried about that net. I'm still gonna flow in the joy of Jesus. Y'all give a Lord a hand clap, amen. And I ain't gotta wait till in the morning either. If you ever find yourself upset and you're going to get upset, keep living. You're going to get upset again. But the next time you get upset, make your mind up, do something like this and just click it off. Because you're the one clicked it on. Click it off. I've had the day I can't do clicking. Click it off. I mean, even if they're a little louder, you just click it off. Somebody say, click it off. Okay, but like, turn the page. Is that more understandable? Just turn the page. Move forward. Jump over that. Delete something. In other words, you're going to resist that evil. And according to scripture, evil going to flee from you. Once you resist, you get into the joy. Oh, Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus. Oh, I won that one. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I won that. Thank you for giving me the ability to endure. Thank you, dear God, for giving me the wisdom not to get, oh, that could have went, oh, Lord, that could have went south. Lord, have mercy. But my flesh didn't get in the way, and those spirits didn't overtake me. I didn't say the thing that I would have said. I spoken to, Lord, have mercy, the thing, and I turned the page. In Jesus' name. And I wild away. I was on the internet. And I saw this little duck. Little duck kept coming to the lemonade stand. And when a duck make it to the lemonade stand, he stand there and look at the lemonade man. And he said to the lemonade man at the lemonade stand, do you have any grapes? Oh, my God, do you have any grapes? The duck made several trips. He said, look, I done told you, I don't have any grapes. I sell lemonade. And the duck wild away. The duck came back to the lemonade stand and he had a conversation with the lemonade man. The lemonade man got a little upset with the duck. He said, look, I don't have any grapes. But I tell you what I'm going to do today. We're going to go to the store, and I'm going to get you some grapes. Then they went to the store, and he wanted to get the duck some grapes. And the duck was in the store, and the man had the grapes. And the duck looked at him and said, do you have any lemonade? But I was in the flow, man. I just saw what God was going, look at here. I said, I needed that, Lord. How can God speak to me through the duck story? Somebody say amen. But if you just look around, there's some things that could spark your joy. Somebody say amen. When I look back at my testimony, I see things that just get me stirred up and cause my heart to be merry, and I get even more thankful to God every time I think about it. But I never went to medical school to be a doctor. Somebody say amen. I never did that. Y'all give a lot of hand, because that wasn't for me. It wasn't for me to do, but I used to play doctor a lot. Somebody say amen. I used to get the syringe and be shooting people up in the arm. They would pay me to shoot them with the needle. And when I look back on that, it's kind of funny to me how the enemy could take over Somebody say amen in Jesus. How the enemy could take over, have you doing things you ain't never been to school for. Somebody say amen. Doing evil, doing harm. And God protected that person, and God protected me. Somebody say amen. I used to do drugs. Amen. God delivered me from that. But I used to shoot up. Amen. How you shoot that stuff. Amen. And folks used to pay me to get the vein. Okay? I would miss the vein a lot. People would be swole, miss. Somebody say amen. Yeah. But in God's saying, see some of the people now since I've been saved, you know, and in the Lord, and they still alive and well, and some of them gave their life to Jesus. Y'all give a lot of still got their arms. Somebody say amen. I remember before I got saved, I had to pray. Because the one lady, her sister's leg was big, just like a watermelon. I said, I don't need to do that no more. I don't think I'm getting your vein. Go get it. Just put it in. I said, okay. But God forgave me. Somebody say amen. But I look back on the stupid stuff I done did in life, and I just laugh at that person. Y'all give a lot. Can you look back and laugh on some stuff? Some crazy stuff that you did? Anybody ever made you jump out the window with a shotgun busting caps at you? And you got away? Have you ever died in the front seat of a van and God brought you back to life? Have you ever been full of them pills and fell down and bust your head on the cement? Somebody say, Jesus, Lord. You ever been full of them bulls? And thought you could whoop the whole world? Lord, ain't God good? Oh, man, I'm so full of joy right now. God is good. I ain't that person I used to be. When y'all hear First Lady saying that, she mean that she ain't the person that she used to be. She be just so full of joy and calling out to God. Thank you. I love God. My poor mama got bought out of every cafe in niggas home. I saw my mom fight the police and survive. Somebody say, man, ain't God good? It's stuff like that that gets you to tap into the joy. I thank God for showering my mama with that mercy and grace and favor. Showering us with mercy, grace, and favor. He looked beyond our faults and saw our needs. He saw how we abused ourselves in the past. And he said, you know what? I'm not going to let that take you out. I'm going to broaden your horizons. Guess what? You're going to have a format to tell somebody about my goodness. And as you tell it, the joy of the Lord going to take all over you. And they're going to understand that there's a hope for them and their children and their children's children. The heavens has declared it. Y'all give the Lord a hand clap. Come on, somebody. Care about no net, no web. Hear people going through stuff, man, just the stuff they need to be told. It says, blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin, you ready? Whose sin is covered. Somebody say, sin covered. Sin covered. Somebody, sin covered. I'm a sinner saved by grace. My sin is covered. Said, my sin is by the blood of Jesus. Y'all give the Lord a hand clap. Come on. Blessed is the man, that person into whom the Lord imputed not iniquity, and in whose spirit there is no guile. Said, ain't no guile in my spirit. It says in Psalm 43, verse 3 and 4, I'm almost through. It says, oh, send out thy light and thy truth. Let them lead me. Light and truth, lead me. Let them bring me into thy holy hill and into thy tabernacle. Then will I go unto the altar of God, unto God, my exceeding joy. Yeah, upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Let me close. Psalm 66, verse 1. Make a joyful noise into God, all ye lands. Sing forth the honor of his name. Make his praise glorious. Say unto God, how terrible art thou in thy works. Thou art through thy greatness, through the greatness of thy power, shall thine enemies submit themselves unto thee. All the earth shall worship thee and shall sing unto thee. They shall sing to thy name, Selah. Come and see the work of God. He is terrible in his doings toward the children of men. He turned the sea into dry land. They went through the flood on foot. There did we rejoice in him. He ruled by his power forever. His eyes behold the nation. Let not the rebellious exalt themselves. Selah. Bless, oh bless our God, ye people, and make the voice of his praise to be heard, which holdeth our soul in life, and suffer not our feet to be moved. For thou, O God, hast proved us, thou hast tried us, as silver is tried. Verse 13, you ready? Last verse. I will go into thy house with burnt offerings, and I will pay thee my vows. Y'all give the Lord a hand clap. Ain't no more burnt offerings. So we're going to read like this. I will go into thine house with the offerings. Somebody say the offerings. And I will pay my vows. And I'm going to be joyful about it. Y'all give the Lord a hand clap. God loves us to call on his name. God gets excited when you call on him. Somebody say amen. He loves hearing from you. It causes him to rejoice. Honorable. More honorable. Somebody say more honorable. Say more honorable. I got to honor you also. Somebody say amen. We are people of honor and we honor. Somebody say amen. Said I am a honorable person. In Jesus' name. I come into his gates with thanksgiving. Somebody saying this tabernacle with praise. The heavens had declared it. I am a child of God. God loves me, always will, and he will honor me. Said God will honor me, and he will hear me when I call. Not just stand there and listen, but when God hear you, God immediately does something. Oh, I say immediately, God does something when you call on him. And God knows about your honor. He knows about your favor. He knows about your sacrifice. Somebody say amen. And God said one day, your gift is going to come up before my face. As a memorial. Somebody say amen in God's house.